Sandra Annette Bland was a 28-year-old black woman who was found hanging in her jail cell in Waller County, Texas on July 13, 2015, 3 days after being arrested during a traffic stop. Her death was ruled a suicide. Let's get straight to it. The background story. Bland was pulled over for a minor traffic violation on July 10th by State Trooper Brian Ancinia. The exchange escalated, resulting in Bland's arrest and a charge of assaulting a police officer. The arrest was partially recorded by Ancinia's dash cam, a bystander cell phone, and Bland's own cell phone. After authorities reviewed the dash cam footage, Ancinia was placed on administrative leave for failing to follow proper traffic stop procedures. Texas authorities and the FBI conducted an investigation into Bland's death and determined the Waller County Jail did not follow required policies, including time checks on inmates and ensuring that employees had completed required mental health training. In December 2015, a grand jury declined to indict the county sheriff and jail staff for a felony relating to Bland's death. The following month, Ancinia was indicted for perjury for making false statements about the circumstances surrounding Bland's arrest. Y'all keep up. In September 2016, Bland's mother settled for a wrongful death lawsuit against the county jail and police department for $1.9 million and some procedural charges. In June 2017, the perjury charge against Ancinia was dropped in return for his agreement to permanently end his career with law enforcement. In 2019, Bland's cell phone video became available to the public and to Bland's family for the first time. This video, however, was not available during the civil trial. An autopsy conducted by the Harris County Institute of Forensic Science concluded that Bland died through asphyxiation and classified the death as a suicide. Police stated that Bland had used a plastic garbage bag to hang herself. Family and friends called for an independent autopsy immediately and stated that it was unlikely Bland would have killed herself. Bland's family said that she was just upbeat about the job she landed with Prairie View A&M University. Her sister said that Bland had no medically diagnosed clinical depression. A friend who spoke with Bland while in jail said she was upbeat despite the arrest. It just makes no sense, she said. Sandy was a soldier. She wasn't fazed about it at all. In March 2016, documents obtained from the forensic lab that performed Bland's autopsy suggested that the time of death was not what was originally reported by official investigations and that this could raise questions about the validity of the original investigation. A report by the Harris County Forensic Investigator contradicted the official report of the Waller County Sheriff's Department about details of the condition of the body. In addition, the document stating the time guards last observed Bland alive in her cell did not agree with the security video footage from the jail where Bland was detained, leaving a discrepancy of an hour. Brandon Wood, director of the Texas Commission on Jail Standards, said that the failure to observe inmates hourly as required by standards could be criminal in nature. An attorney for the Bland family said that it might just be a clerical error or it might be something more nefarious. Waller County Sheriff R. Glenn Smith, who ran the jail where Bland died, y'all keep up, has been placed in charge of Waller County's investigation into her death. Smith was suspended and fired from his previous post as a chief of police of Hempstead after alleged incidents of racism and brutality. So the aftermath. The Prairie View City Council voted to rename the street Sandra was arrested on to Sandra Bland Parkway, the Sandra Bland Act. Texas Senate Bill 1849, also known as the Sandra Bland Act, went into effect on September 1st, 2017 and mandated change to corrections and police policy when dealing with those with substance abuse or mental health concerns. Bland's mother, Geneva Reed Veal, is a member of the Mothers of the Movement, bringing attention to police reform, Bland's story, and the grief process of losing a child. Shout out to her mother, keep on fighting the good fight. You have my support 100%. Sandra Bland even had her own YouTube channel where she spoke about positivity and black empowerment. I have been subscribed to it for years now and will put it in the link in the description. Now, my take, there is no doubt in my mind that Sandra Bland was murdered. There are too many facts in the investigation that showcase foul play, such as the officials lying about the time of the discovery of the body, falsifying info about the details of her body when she passed, the patrol officer being found guilty of perjury for making false statements in regards of her arrest, officials stating different times of when she was found dead, the times of her being last seen alive being different than what was reported, the sheriff who ran the jail having a background of racial brutality. Too many red flags to simply ignore it and rule it a suicide. Sandra Bland was a powerful and prideful black woman who was murdered in the hands of this racist-ass system, and it's a damn shame no one has been charged with her murder. And for all of y'all racist police supporting motherfuckers who object to what I'm saying, it's all good. One day, even if I'm not allowed to see it, the truth about this case will come out. Say her name, RIP Sandra Bland. My condolences to her family. And again, shout out to her mother. Y'all know what it is, man. Until next time.